Z-grafting, when your scions have a larger diameter than your rootstocks. Z-grafting main steps. Start by making a 45 degree cut in the rootstock. Make a smaller cut at the edge of the first cut. Make a vertical cut starting at the point where both cuts meet. After doing the same identical cuts in the scion, adjust both pieces firmly. Tie the graft using parafilm or tape. Grafting a thin rootstock using the Z-grafting technique. Traditional grafting techniques won't work when grafting larger diameter scions to very young rootstocks. 1. Make a 45 degree cut in the scion and in the rootstock. Invert the scion before making the cut. 2 cuts should have the same angle. 2. Make 1 small cut at both edges. 3. Make a vertical cut. Use the top of the smaller cut as a guide for the starting point. Four. Insert the scion on top of the rootstock and adjust firmly. This type of graft has multiple cambium contact points, so it rarely fails. 5. Tie the graft. I prefer to use a rubber tape, but other tying materials will also work. 6. Cover the scion with parafilm to avoid dehydration. Depending on the location of the rootstock and the time of year, this step may not be needed. Protecting the graft with aluminium foil may also be used if grafting in a field. Here's a magnified review of all the steps of this grafting technique so you can see every detail. No comment. mistakes to avoid. All the cuts should be as straight as possible. Make sure you use a sharp knife. Since most thin rootstocks may be difficult to cut straight with a grafting knife, using pruning shears might be a good alternative. Important: don't forget to invert the normal position of the scion before making the cut. Make sure that both cuts have the same 45 degree angle. The length of both vertical cuts should be identical. If one of the cuts is longer, one of the top flaps won't make a good cambium contact. Make the other cut longer to correct the problem. Better, but still not perfect. The graft will still work with the other cambium contact points. Results. I'm removing the tape so we can check on the graft progress. This is what the graft looks like after 35 days. New cell growth, known as callus, can be seen in all the cambium contact point areas. Here's the second graft, also after 35 days. I usually don't remove the tape for several months. Being elastic, it will end up falling off by itself. If you enjoy my work, don't forget to click the like button. Leave a comment and share the video to show your appreciation. Be sure to turn on all notifications on your device so you know when one of my videos is published. Thanks for watching.